week on Storyboard, ITC's health and hygiene brand Savlon has introduced Braille-enabled packs for their antiseptic liquid on World Side Day. We catch up with Sameer Satpathy, Chief Executive Personal Care Products Business, ITC Limited, and Piyush Pandey, Executive Chairman, Ogilvy India, and speak to them about the new packs and what is the larger impact that they expect out of it. After last year's touch of care, Vicks is back with its latest tearjerker. We speak to Ritu Mittal, Country Marketing Manager, Vicks India, on the sidelines of this new campaign launch. And True Caller says it is sabke liye. How? We find out on this week's notice board. Hello and welcome to Storyboard. This is Shivani Gharat. ITC's health and hygiene brand Savlon recently introduced Braille-enabled packs for their antiseptic liquid on World Side Day. ITC is calling this new packaging their commitment towards an inclusive society. These Braille-enabled packs have been designed in a way to make the product easily available to those who are visually impaired. How much time did ITC take to roll out this new packaging? How is the brand spreading awareness about it? And what is the larger impact that they expect out of it? We have all these questions answered as we speak to Sameer Satpathy, Chief Executive Personal Care Products Business ITC Limited, and Piyush Pandey, Executive Chairman, Ogilvy India. Let's take a look at the new packs and their new campaign. Sameer, Piyush, welcome to CNBC TV 18.
Thank you, Shivani.
It is a great initiative, I think, and I always say that, you know, accessibility when it comes to differently abled individuals is one of the biggest issues in our country. How did you arrive upon this thought of introducing a packaging like this for Savlon?
Certain relationships don't need briefs, and Sameer works very closely with my two CCOs, who are Harshad and Kenaz. So when he comes up with an idea, he'll share it with them. When they have an idea, they don't wait for a brief. We have done some good things that the world has recognized in the past. So the team came up with the idea, shared it with Sameer, not with me. And Sameer said, yes, we are on. And the implementation of that, nobody knew. We didn't know how difficult it is, how easy it is. But the team shared it with Sameer, and Sameer said, I'll make it happen. So, get another move in the direction of saying Savlon cares.
Sameer, how much time did it take for you to introduce and, you know, turn around your product packaging to make it Braille-enabled?
I think I'll speak for the team over here. So, it's not me. I think it's a large team, which is the brand team, the agency team. There's also the manufacturing and the packaging team. I think they all love the idea. And they thought it was the right thing to do, not only for the brand, but for society. And once people believe and they want to do something, they make it happen. There were obviously some hiccups, there were some things, but everybody knew and everybody was working to the same plan. And I think they managed to do it in 3-4 months, which is, I think, quite good.
You mentioned hiccups. What were the key challenges, you know, because you already have your products on shelves. Mm-hmm. So what were the challenges that, you know, you faced initially when you thought of coming up with a product that too on a particular day?
You know, it's something what, you know, somebody said, hey, you must be very brave to do something like this. So I said, no, actually, you don't need to be brave to do good things, right? So I think the whole thing was just putting it together and making it happen. And there is no, it's not about and making sure that it happens and it happens in the right manner. And it's executed on scale because you don't want to do it for a select period on select things. You wanted to make it mass, you wanted to go everywhere. So how quickly can you change over supply chains? How do you get your partners in the supply chain to move? How do you get your factories to do things a little differently than what they were doing? So it involves some amount of engineering, involves a lot of people. But because people saw what was trying to be done, so they went out of their way to make sure that, you know, this got priority because everybody's got a day job, right? And make it happen. Not only that, when we look at people on, you know, even the commercials which were done, you know, done by Bob from Good Morning, he went out of his way to make sure that, you know, he gave it priority. he shot it the way he shot it. He shot it with his heart, right? So, when you tend to do good things, the universe conspires to help you.
So this product from today will be available across all stores across the country?
We're shipping it from, the deadline was to ship it from today. I'm happy to say we started shipping it maybe 3-4 days back. But over the next 4 to 8 weeks, you will start seeing it shelves across the country. Because it depends on the pipeline, how much stock was already there, and, old stock replacing the new. But it will be available across the country.
It is a great thought. It is a great idea. And, I'm sure it will require enough amount of effort to create awareness that such a product is available on the shelves. I saw the campaign and it looks really nice. What was the thought behind creating a campaign like this? And, how did you execute the whole idea?
I think, again, it is how deep you feel. It is not rocket science. That a brand which is... has done work on caring, should do a thing for caring. It should be honest, it should be authentic, and it should be taken to people. Definitely it's meant for visually impaired, but your users also must know that your brand cares. So what we are going to do is that we are going to not spend too much money advertising it, but there are so many associations, and they must know. And once the pack is there, everywhere, then I think there must be some plans to do it. Are we going to put money behind it? I think yes.
So, Sameer, you mentioned how to do good things. You don't need to be brave. So, tell me, what is the larger impact that you expect from this particular initiative of yours?
Well, we would know we have succeeded if maybe 5 years down the line, we walk into a shop and find that most brands have followed this, then we would know we would have succeeded, because it makes sense for everybody to do it.
Okay. Before this, both the team that you have, along with Piyush's team, has created Savlon Healthy Hands, and we have covered it extensively on our show. So are you or is Savlon moving towards being a brand or, company with purpose?
See, ITC has always been a company with purpose, and our brands just follow the company purpose, right? We've always said that brands live in society. And because they need, they take from society, but they need to give back. Because when you give back, society becomes more inclusive, becomes better. And that's always good for the brands, it's always good for society. So it's a very symbiotic relationship. And as far as Savlon specifically is concerned, it's always done things, I think it's credit to the larger team which works on it, which is progressive, which is a little ahead of its time, which I think is making a real difference to people's lives. And also, they've been doing the business well, which I think is a byproduct than the aim.
Okay, so, in fact, Healthy Hands did receive a lot of, a lot of traction across not just in our country, but, it was appreciated. The world appreciated the whole initiative. What was the kind of impact on brand Savlon after that campaign?
See, the thing is, first of all, just one correction. It's not a campaign, it's the way we are doing things. So as we speak, it's not a one-time activity. So what maybe the world sees is that one time a spike, which you see in some advertising or, sometimes we get some awards. But what I think it's a daily activity. We go to thousands of schools. We do it on a daily basis. We go and teach children about good hygiene habits. We teach them how to wash their hands and why that is important for their, for overall health. Because we do believe that if you have healthier children, the country will be in a better place. So we do it on a daily basis. So it's not a one-time, advertising campaign. It's the way we work. And is it helping us? Absolutely. Does it help us in terms of business? It always makes good business sense, right? But I think that's been the ITC philosophy of triple bottom line, that we are saying that we'll be good for not only for profits, but also for society and also for the environment. We have to balance all these stakeholders out today. It's not about tomorrow.
So we are seeing this new packaging for Savlon. Do we see a rollout with as far as the other ITC brands and other SKUs of Savlon is concerned?
See, we started off and we picked up Savlon, and there is a reason why we picked Savlon, because for the visually impaired, what does happen is things which are in regular use, is they know where it is and they're using it on a daily, for example, a hand wash. They know it's next to the sink and they use it every time they wash their hands. But something like an antiseptic may not be on daily use. It's lying somewhere in a shelf and the day in a cupboard. That you need it at infrequent intervals. But when you need it, you need it. And you may not have felt nearby. So this helps them do that. But I'm sure that other brands which are of the ilk or which are of this kind of usage will shift very quickly into that.
Thank you so much. Thanks for speaking to us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
I represent National Association for the Blind India, which is the largest NGO in the field of blindness. And I also represent the end user of this product. At the outset, I congratulate ITC and Savlon for conceiving this idea and implementing it. So it's a great initiative that some product which is very essential for a common person to make it Braille enabled. I mean, I don't know how this idea has come to their mind, but this is, you know, an antiseptic cream which is generally used by everyone and especially by visually impaired, because visually impaired persons are more prone for wounds, you know, and a product which is easily available and which is Braille enabled is absolutely a great thing, and I feel that other FMCGs should follow the suit and make the products accessible and Braille enabled or disabled friendly, I would say.
It is time for us to slip into a short break. On the other side of this break, we take a look at Brandwick's latest tearjerker and also speak to Ritu Mittal, Country Marketing Manager, Wix India.